Hey, it's John and Enduring Charm. So today's video is kind of a follow-up from a previous one, and I'll be testing this compressor here. It's the Fortress, which is a Harbor Freight house brand. And the model, where is the model? It is an FT2135U. So I have that right? FT2135UQ, I'm sorry. So this particular compressor, its claim to fame is that it's ultra quiet. We're gonna test that. And the size of it is something where you would probably use it for finish nailers and that kind of thing. It's not a huge compressor. The ratings are 135 PSI maximum pressure and 2.1 SCFM at 90. So that's not a lot. It's certainly enough to run finish nailers, but I wanna see, you know, what its performance is gonna be. And the previous video I just did was on this pancake compressor, which has a little bit higher specs. And, you know, the real question in my mind is, which is a better buy? If you're doing typical, you know, finished carpentry, maybe occasional framing nailer, you know, is this the better buy, the pancake compressor? Or something like this going to be better for you, especially since this claims to have features that, you know, might be important, like quiet, being quiet. So we're going to test this and see what we can figure out in comparison between the two. All right, just briefly, we'll look at some of the features here. So I do see some things that I like. There's a place to wrap the cord, which is always important because I hate when the cord's just flopping around. You know, it has a cage around it, but, you know, I have to say, if you're going to use this on a job site, you know, there is a lot of stuff hanging out here that could get caught on things, because you're wrapping cords, you know, electrical cords and air hoses, things get wrapped up, and there are places here for things to get caught. If you look at a pancake compressor, you know, it's a much cleaner line, and there's less places for things to get caught. This pancake compressor has a recessed area for the dials, for the gauges, so they don't get, you know, buggered up if they're on the back of a truck or whatever. This, you know, there's a little bit more problem as far as that. I mean, the dials are recessed, but, you know, you definitely have areas here that could get caught. The cage is nice for some of the internal stuff, but I wouldn't say it's as clean as a pancake style compressor. There are two ports here, two air ports, which is good, because even if you can't run two nail guns or something off of this at the same time, it may not have enough power. It's still nice to have two ports, because if one goes bad and you're in the middle of the job, you know, you can always plug into the other one. Plus, you may use one nailer at a time, but still have both plugged in, you know what I mean? So that's good. It has nice rubber feet. It does have, this is so important, it has a just a lever here. It's a ball style valve to drain it out at the end of the day, and that's just nice and clean, not going to have any problems with that. And it's located easy area to reach. However, I do have to say, you know, this is a place again where cords could get caught. You know, you're dragging an electrical cord or an air hose through here and it could get caught on that, so a little bit of a pain there perhaps. Now this is supposed to be very quiet. We're going to test that shortly. But you see some more things hanging off here. It's like a little kind of a muffler thing here. I'm not sure what's going on. Anyway, we'll see how that holds up. But as far as using it on the job site, I'd say it's a little bit of a high maintenance kind of thing, in the sense that there are some things hanging off of it when compared to a pancake compressor. The emergency valve here to let off steam if you need to is located deep in here, which I actually like better, because on the pancake compressor, it's hanging out and it's easy to get caught, and sometimes it just, you lose all your air because it gets caught on something. So I actually like that it's hidden in this one. All right, here's how I'm going to do this. I've done other videos where I tested the noise levels of various tools, and compressors were part of that. And in those videos, I registered the maximum decibel as a way of comparing. In this test, I'm going to do it a little bit differently. What I'm going to do is power this thing on. We'll see how long it takes to get to its maximum pressure, which is an important point. And I'm just going to hold this decibel meter near the unit itself. Now, this is maybe not a fair test in the sense that I'm holding this very close, and the closer you get, the louder it's going to be. However, this is the same way I tested the other compressor in that different video, so I want to keep consistent as far as that. And in this case, I'm not going to register the maximum decibel. I'm just going to see where it tends to average out. Now, this thing claims to be very, very quiet. It claims to be 60 decibel, which is very quiet, but we're going to find out. So I'm going to turn this thing on at a mark, and we'll see how long it takes to fill up, and we'll just take a look at this meter. Here we go. Wow, okay, that was quick. I'm actually shocked. That was 50 seconds. So that's a very quick fill up. Now, again, it's only 135 PSI. So that's, you know, much less than the 175 PSI of the pancake compressor I tested. Nonetheless, 50 seconds is very quick. The pancake compressor took 2 minutes and 45 seconds. And that's really an impressive, 50 seconds is very impressive. Now the noise levels were interesting. So they were centering around high 60s or 70 decibel. Now the box claims 60 decibels, which is much less, but they may be measuring from a further distance and, you know, my meter could be a slightly off or whatever. So it actually, I mean, 70 sounds a lot higher than the 60 on the box, but I have to say it's extremely quiet. 70 is not objectionable at all. You can easily have a conversation over this thing running. It would be kind of like a refrigerator running or a dishwasher running, something like that. I mean, that's the sound level that we're talking about. You can easily talk over it. So I'm actually very impressed with the sound level. Even though it doesn't match what's on the box, I really can't complain. That's very, very low. All right, let's do another test here and we'll see how quick the recovery is and where it starts to kick in. So we're at 100, actually it looks like more like 130, but in the range of 135. And I'm just going to use this, I got this air hose connected here, I'm just going to use this blowgun to blow off some air, and I just want to see where this kicks back on. Oh, before I do that, I'm going to set the air level here. So let's see, do you pull or push? Well, that's interesting. Well, that's starting to come up. This thing, I'm not sure what the point of this is. Weird. All right. I got the air coming up now. I'm going to set it at 90. I'm going to set it at 90. All right, getting back to our test here. I'm going to blow off some air and we'll just see where this comes back on. All right, recovery is pretty quick, and it came on in the vicinity of 100 PSI. So it varies roughly between 100 and 135. Recovery time, not too bad. And it definitely, you know, I'm getting the idea that it is much quieter than any other compressor I've used. And two more things just to show you. The way you turn it on and off is this power switch right here, which is kind of similar to a bigger compressor. All right, so that's off. And then to drain it, all you got to do is just flip this valve. And that drains really quickly. That's nice. All right, so what's the final verdict here? For one thing, let me just mention this whole handle problem I was having. I guess it's just me because, you know, most, in fact, every compressor I've ever had, there's a regulator adjustment and you push or pull to lock it in place so that it doesn't accidentally change, you know, when you're using it. And that's this pancake compressor. That's how it works. It says right on it, pull to adjust and push to lock. This one I kind of assumed was the same way, but clearly it isn't. It just happens to be, I don't know why they did it, but there's an extra handle on top of the other one. It doesn't do anything. It's just there for extra, you know, extra stuff to grab. So this doesn't have a lock apparently. It just moves. So in a way that's a downside and it's kind of weird, But once you're aware of it, you know, you can use it. It's not that big a deal. So what is the better buy here? Should you, because the cost is similar. This one's $159, this one's $139. So they're in the same general ballpark. Which is the better buy? This one has higher air pressure, you know, 175 versus 135. And the SCFM rating is higher on this one than on this one. You got 3 here versus 2.1 here. Does that make a difference? Well, yes and no. Recovery time is something to think about as well. This one is much faster. I'm actually shocked at how much faster it is to recover than this one. And initial startup is much quicker too. So we're at 50 seconds here versus 2 minutes and 45 seconds here. So that's a big difference. You know, weight-wise, if you're carrying this to a job site, the pancake compressor is a little bit less weight than this one, but not a huge amount. You know, it's not going to make a huge difference, I don't think. Convenience-wise, you know, when you're in a room with a bunch of cords and all getting tangled up, you know, this one is going to experience more as far as getting things tangled up versus a pancake compressor, which has smooth sides and you can drag cords around it. It's not going to get caught up. But, you know, if you're in an environment where you're doing finish work and you're being a little more careful, you don't have other trades around you, then, you know, I don't think there's really a problem with this. One big plus of this is the noise level, and they have done a very good job as far as noise. Even though it didn't match what was pointed out on the box here as far as my decibel meter, I have to say it's very quiet. I really have no complaints about the noise level. That's a huge plus, and being, you know, partially deaf as it is, you know, that's something I will definitely think about when I decide which one to bring to a job site. And I think customers would be happy to have a quieter machine as well. It's a big deal. Since the recovery time is so quick, I would say that the capacity differences between the two don't make that big of a deal. Now, if you're running a framing nailer or a couple framing nailers or something like that, I think this unit is going to choke and you're probably going to want to go with a bigger one. But unless you're really banging on this thing, I would say this would be more pleasant to use, and I don't think there's going to be a big performance difference between the two in the real world. So to bottom line this thing, I think I'm leaning towards this model here. I think that's a better buy for the price, and you're getting, you know, a better bargain because of the noise level, because of the recovery time versus the pancake compressor. And the only reason, now that I own both, that I would purchase this over this one would be if you work in an environment where there's definitely a lot of cords getting tangled all the time, and or if you're in an environment where you're dragging this thing around, like, all, you know, 3 or 4 or 5 times a day, you're dragging this thing to another floor, moving it around or whatever, then I might go that route. But as far as a, you know, remodeling situation where you have, you know, people in the house and you're working in close quarters to the compressor, the quiet factor is a big deal. And because the price is very close, I would say this is the better bargain. So I would push you towards buying this unless, you know, you have some of those other issues to think about. Overall, I'm pretty impressed with the unit. This little handle thing, once I got it sorted out, it's not that big a deal. It's just a little weird. So I'd say overall, they've done a pretty good job with this thing.